Hello, I am Professor N.B. Hulle from G.H. Raisoni Institute of Engineering and Technology. Here, this is the last video regarding the Smith chart, and in this video, we will see some different examples related to the double stub matching. The difference between the previous video and this video is that in this case, the distance between the stub from the load is lambda by 18. In the previous example, we have seen that the first stub is located at the load itself and second stub is separated by maybe the 3 lambda by 8 or maybe lambda by 4 and so on. So here we will see how will be the methodology for this particular calculation. Here in this case, this is the transmission line terminated by some load which is ZR. In this case, the normalized value is that is 0.467. Now here, previously we are locating the first stub at the load itself and the second stub is located at some distance and the separation between the two stubs is something. This distance is maybe lambda by 4, lambda by 8 or maybe 3 lambda by 4 and so on. Now here in this particular example, what we are planning and how is the case? Now here is the transmission line terminated by some load impedance. In this case, again, the same value we have, that is 0.467. And here, the first stub is not located at the load, but it is located at a distance of, this much distance. And this distance is given here in this particular case, which is given as lambda by 18. This value is given as lambda by 18. And second stub is located at, or spacing, exactly the spacing between the two stubs is 3 lambda by 8, means this is the stub number 1 and this is the stub number 2. This is the stub number 2 and this distance is given here and which is given as that is 3 lambda by 8. This is given as 3 lambda by 8. Now we have to follow some different procedure as compared to the other examples. Now here in this case, I will start with this example. Now here, it has a four solutions to be exact and I will find out only the two solutions, that is solution number 1 and solution number 2, and I will give the hints or tricks for the remaining two solutions. All the four solutions are the correct, but feasibility we have to check it out for the other two solutions. Here in this case, I will start with the stub number 2 because always for taking the reference here, I will show something like this. Always, this is the stub number 2. Stub number 2 is where we have the load is going to match. Yes, this circle, on this particular circle, the stub number 2 is going to lie. And always with reference to this, we have to find out the location of the stub number 1 and so on. But here in this case, this is the location of the stub number 2 and 1. Now here in this case, on this circle the stub number 1 is going to lie and on this particular circle the stub number 2 is going to lie. And as in this example, the distance between the two stubs is given as 3 lambda by 8. That's why I have done first initially the stub number 1 circle and circle for the stub number 2, and then we are plotting here. This is the load impedance, that is 0.467, and we have to convert this impedance to the admittance. Again, similar common is the process here. This is the value of the load admittance, and load admittance is 0.14 plus J0. Now, how is the process? Now, the process is that here in this case, this is the load, right? And the stub number two. Is connected at, stub number 2 is located at the distance of lambda by 18, this much. And here we are at the load and we are traveling towards the generator. Means from this point, because here is the load, from this point we have to travel in the clockwise direction by the distance of lambda by 18. Now here we have to extend this point outside and from this particular point we have to travel by lambda by 18 and then we have to locate everything. Now here in this case, This distance we have taken as lambda by 18, which is 0.056 lambda, and then we are plotting this particular point here, because here in this case whatever the circle we will draw here, this complete circle will be S circle, that is taking center as this and S circle, and this is the part of the S circle, means just we are projecting that particular point, and we will read out its coordinate. Its coordinates are 1.5 minus j.78. Miss, here this is the impedance on the transmission line, because impedance on the transmission line changes as we will travel along the transmission line here. Now here impedance or admittance at this point here, I'm talking about admittance. Admittance at this point is 0.14 plus j0. But if I'm traveling in this direction by this much distance, which is lambda by 18 in this case, the impedance along or admittance along this transmission line is going to change. At this point, this is the admittance, which is the 1.5 minus j.78 mho is the value of the load admittance at that particular point on the transmission line, or impedance admittance on the transmission line. Then here we have to project this particular point on the transmission, on the circle, on the circle on which we are going to locate the stub number 1 on this particular circle. Now look at here, there are the two possibilities. One possibility is here we can plot here, or we can plot here. And here in this case we are not going to allow to change this value, real part. We are allowing only to change the imaginary part. Right, we are allowing to change only the imaginary part. Two possible solutions under this solution one, two solutions are there. One is plotting at here this particular point, and second is this. I will prefer the second, because second solution is, or this point solution is better than the first one. That's why I'm selecting the second one. Now read out the admittance at that particular point. Admittance is 1.5. look at here, this part, this real part here as well as here is the same. We are not allowing to change the real part, because we are inserting only the susceptance, that is imaginary part. And here this is this admittance of the transmission line at that particular point after the insertion of the stub. That's why from this particular point we are able to calculate the susceptance of the stub number 1 as well as its values. The susceptance of the line after inserting the stub number 1 at lambda by 18 is this value. So susceptance of the stub is that is final value minus initial value. Final value is this, final value is this, that is 1.95 minus initial value, that is minus j.78. its value is a point, and that is minus j 1.7. here if we are looking at minus j 1.7, this is 1.6, here is somewhere 1.7, and 1.17 is somewhere here, and we will mark that particular point somewhere here, that is minus j 1.17, and here we are able to find out its distance from the short circuited end. As I previously discussed, we have, this is the open circuit end for the admittances, and this is the short circuit stub, short circuit point for the admittances. Now this is the value location of the length of the stub number 2. The length of the stub number 2, we are able to get this value here, which is as 0.121 lambda is the length of the stub number 1. Now here further to find out its value, we have to locate this particular point on this circle, that is r is equal to 1 circle, which is somewhere here. This is here, right? And here again the two solutions are possible. One is we can project this particular point after the insertion, this particular point may be somewhere here, or maybe somewhere here. This again two solutions are possible here. Now here in this case I am not looking for this solution, because in this particular case the length of the stub will be the more. That's why I am preferring this particular solution under the solution number 1. Now here in this case, this point if I am choosing, its value will be 1 plus j 1.65, and to cancel out this value, cancel out here this 1.65 value. We have to connect the stub of minus 1.65. Minus 1.65, it is somewhere here. This is 1.6, 1.65 is somewhere here, and we are looking at that from the short circuited point. This is 1.65, this is 1.65, and if we are calculating its distance, its distance is coming to be that is 0.087 lambda. This is the length of the stub number 1 as well as length of the stub number 2 for the double stub matching as far as this example is concerned. Similarly, with the same example, I will try to find out the second solution or solution number 2. Here, in this case, if we are going for the solution number 2, the process is common, data is everything is common. Now here, this is the circle on which we are going to plot the stub number 2, then the stub number 2 and stub number 1, these two stubs are separated by the 3 lambda by 8, that is nothing but this particular value. Now here, procedure is common, we are plotting the impedance, then we are converting the impedance to the admittance, and now here is the difference. We are taking the location of the stub number 1 from the load is lambda by 18, which is 0.06 lambda. Then we are plotting here. Now, up to this, the procedure is common for the solution number 1 as well as for the solution number 2. Now, here in this case, now in the previous example or previous solution number 1, what I have done, I traveled along this line and I join somewhere here, something like this. But in place of that, what is my motto? My motto is that project this particular point on this circle. The possibility is maybe here or maybe here. In the previous case example, I considered this previous solution. Now here I will consider this, then we will see what will happen for the solution. Now here is the case, read out its coordinates. Its coordinates are 1.5 minus 0.21 is the value. Now here from this value, we are able to find out the value of the stub here, which is 0.57, because acceptance of the stub after line inserting is this value, that is any final value minus the initial value will be this, that is point plus 0.57. Now here is the 0.6, 0.57, maybe somewhere here. Now look at, from the short circuited end, if I am taking in this direction here up to this point, now look at the length of the stub, which is more as compared to the solution number 1. That's why I prefer the solution number 1. Now here in this case, if we are finding that particular value here, this will be the length of the stub number 1, which is 0.332 lambda. Now here, now we have to take, this is the final point. We have to take this is as a center and we have to draw the circle. This we have to project this particular point on the circle, maybe on the upper side or maybe on the bottom side. That depends. Again, that will give the solution, two solutions here. Now here in this case, again the two solutions are possible. One is we are able to project this point maybe here or maybe here, but I have preferred this one. Right, we can prefer other also. Means number of solutions are possible for the similar example. Now here its value is 1 minus j 0.5, and here we are able to find out the susceptance of the stub number 2 is to cancel out this value. We have to connect the stub of plus 0.5 value, that is plus j 0.5 value, which is somewhere here. And if we are traveling from the same point, that is short circuit end, to calculate that value. Now here in this case, the length of the stub number 2 is 0.034 lambda. Now these are the some tricks and methods which are used for the calculation of the stub number 1, stub number 2, and location of the stub number 1, maybe sometimes at the load, maybe sometimes situated at the distance. Here in this particular case, the distance is given by lambda by 18 and so on. Means these are the tricks we have to follow, we have to use while finding the length and the location of the stub number 1 and stub number 2 in case of the double stub matching. That's all for the Smith chart. For any queries, you can contact me online. I'm available and I'm try to give the solution to your queries. Thank you.